So, this is part 4 of chapter 1. Whatever doubts that you come across while reading the chapter, please write it down on a piece of paper so that you are well ready whenever we meet next time and you can ask your doubts. So, please do that and let's again start. So, this is part 4 of chapter 1, and until now, in all the three previous parts, we have only talked about the transformation that humans have experienced in the past. So, we have talked about how hominoids changed into hominids and hominids branches like the Homo erectus, Homo habilis, and Homo sapiens. So, we have all talked about the physical changes that has gone by in the past millions of years. But now the question is raised that what is the center of human origin? Like, where was the place on which we can say the humans were first found? So, for this, there are two types of theories, and both these theories are even now debatable because these are extremely divergent views, and both of them have some points against them and some points in support of them. So, first theory is the regional continuity model. So, this regional continuity model says that there was not just one center where the humans emerged. Like, there were simultaneously various centers around the globe, that is, around the world, where humans started developing what they were. So, they said that they supported the idea that instead of just being one center of human origin, there can be multiple regions of origin around the world. While the second theory is just the opposite, and it is called by the name of replacement model, and it says that there was only single center of origin of humans, and that too was found in Africa. Now, according to the regional continuity model, the Homo sapiens in different regions gradually evolved at different rates. So, in this theory, they say that humans have gradually developed simultaneously in different centers of the world at different rates. Even the rate of development was different, but all sorts of development were happening simultaneously all around the world, and they were transforming themselves into the modern humans in all these centers simultaneously. So the supporting point for this theory is that there has been a appearance of variations in the modern humans. Like, people from Africa look different, people from the Southeast Asian countries look different. So these types of differences became the supporting point of this theory that since all these humans look different, their physical, their facial structure is different, then probably they were developing at different rates in different part of the world, and this is why these variations have occurred. So this argument is based on the regional differences in the features of the present day humans. So according to those who advocate this view, these dissimilarities due to the differences between the pre-existing Homo erectus and Homo heidelbergensis, so different branches of humans that were present who were developing at different rates in different parts, and because of the different rate of development, the present day humans in different parts of the world are different. So this is the most important supporting point for the regional continuity model. Now, the replacement model visualizes that there was a complete replacement everywhere of humans with one sort of human people which came from Africa. Now, in Africa, the modern humans developed, and from Africa, all these humans started migrating to different parts of the world. And since they were genetically more advanced, they had higher intelligence, that is why they replaced the entire population of humans, whatever were existing in different parts of the world. The supporting part or the supporting point for this theory is that there is evidence of genetic and anatomical homogeneity of modern humans. Now, even though our facial features are different all around the world, but mostly our physical structure is the same. We have the same intelligence level, we have the same hands, legs, our anatomy, the internal organs, all are same. So this is the most important supporting point for the replacement continuity model, which says that if you just leave the facial differences, all other features are same in the humans, and that is why it is most probable that the humans had emerged in one center, and from that center, that is Africa, they must have migrated to different parts of the world, replacing all other ancient humans that were existing then. So scholars who hold this view suggest that the physical differences observed today. Now, there were people who criticized the replacement model by saying that if you are saying that all of us are same because we came from the same center of origin, then tell us about the differences that we have present in the present day. Like, for example, people in Southeast Asian countries and Africa are completely different looking. So why are these differences? So the supporters of this theory said that because of the acclimatization, or since people were trying to accommodate to the local conditions of the place where they had migrated to, these differences might have generated over the period of time. But because we are coming from the same center of origin, that is Africa, most of our physical structure, most of our anatomical structure is the same. So these are the two varying theories which talk about what can be the center of origin for humans. One is the regional continuity model, which talks about multiple regions altogether, and the second is the replacement model, which says that there was only one center of origin, that is Africa, and from Africa people migrated to different parts of the world. Okay, now the next topic for today is the ways of obtaining food. Now we have talked about the transformations in humans, we have talked about the center of origin. Now, these people also must have had certain ways of extracting or getting food. So these methods are given in this subtopic. So here they say that there were most importantly four types of activities that these humans must have carried out. And these four activities are gathering, hunting, scavenging, and fishing. So they say that early humans would have obtained food through a number of ways, and which is gathering, hunting, scavenging, and fishing. So gathering means that they used to gather, or they used to preserve food that they have collected, like for example, plant food such as seeds, nuts, berries, fruits, and tubers. They must have collected and stored for a longer period of time and had consumed them gradually as the time passed. But this gathering practice, again, there is no direct evidence for this. We cannot blindly accept the fact that people were so advanced that they used to gather food. So, and to prove this point also, okay, whether there was gathering being practiced or not, even for that we do not have direct evidence. Evidence would have been something which was accidentally burned. So something which is burned is much easily preserved by the nature. So if those kinds of evidence were present at this point of time, then the historians would have been strongly supported the idea that gathering activity was practiced. But since we do not have any direct evidence, we assume the fact that probably gathering was one of the activities how the humans were trying to survive, or how they were trying to obtain food. Second important point is hunting. Now, hunting again is debatable because we are not sure whether the humans at that time had so much caliber to hunt large animals. So there is a debate whether it was hunting or it was scavenging. Scavenging is something when the large animals kill the small animals, and those dead bodies were later on extracted by the humans for their own consumption. So they must have not killed the animals themselves because they did not have the proper tools or the skill to kill the animals, and they therefore fed themselves on the dead bodies of the animals which were preyed upon by the larger animals. But again, this cannot be true also because humans had intelligence at that time, and probably they also had developed implements to do hunting. So again, hunting is a debatable issue, whether hunting was being done or scavenging was being done, or maybe both were being used as activities for obtaining food by the humans. This again is debatable. So everything in this chapter is debatable. Nothing can be said with 100% confidence, because we are talking about something which has happened millions of years ago, and we do not have any direct evidence to corroborate the facts that we believe in right now. And last is the fishing activity. Again, fishing is said to be one of the activities. It is evident from the discovery of fish bones. But this again is can only be trusted for a few of the places where fish bones, the evidence of fish bones have been available. So we cannot vouch for this fact that this was correct for the entire of the world. But the places where we have had discovery of fish bones, we can say that fishing was an important activity of survival of the humans by feeding themselves. So the last point here in this subtopic is that did men and women have different roles in these activities? So nowadays the historians have a very good practice of comparing the present day societies. Earlier also I have said that in India in itself, like Andaman and Nicobar, there are certain tribal groups still who are considered to be the most primitive humans because they have not changed at all with the modernization of the world. They are still living the life of the ancient man. So the historians, what they do, they try to draw parallels between these societies which live according to their ancient times and try to find out information about the past societies. So what these historians say is that it is probable that the activities were divided between males and females, their roles were divided. But we do not really know, because today we find societies that live by hunting and gathering, where women and men undertake a range of different activities. But it is not always possible to try to compare present with the past. It can always be different in different scenarios. So this was today's part. Let's carry on with the further subtopics in the next part. See you. Take care. Bye.